Well, YouTube, today at PowerCheck Repair, we got a Lenovo 80QQ IdeaPad 100-100-15iBD or 151BD. Depends how bad your sticker is on the bottom of the laptop. Alright, the problem is the PowerCheck, which is moving like crazy, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna take it apart and replace the jack on this laptop. We do have a repair of this laptop from in prior videos, so if you don't see something on this video, some angle is missing, just check our channel. I'm sure we're gonna have something here as well. So somebody lost a screw right there. Another screw missing right there. See any more screws. Could be screws right here under those, but could be not, go figure. Alright. Will this be removable, or it's gonna be removable after I take the cover off? That doesn't seem like it's removable. Alright. Here we got probably hidden hinges right under here. We hope. But here. Let's see if we can lift up this. Or even if we should lift it up, I'm not sure. I guess I need to see a video of this repair from the previous time to be 100% sure what the problem is. And there is no problem yet. It's just the keyboards are usually lifted up easier from that side. Maybe this one picks up like that. So just hold on 1 second. Let me see how I'm gonna open it up first. And then you could. That's in no way how I wanna work on this laptop. Now, I'm pretty sure I need to take the keyboard out for sure. Yeah, I'm sure the keyboard is holding down. The screws on the keyboard should be holding something down. Okay, so the problem is that it's glued to the casing. That's the problem. Or maybe somebody spilled something in there. Yeah, there is a glue strip right here, glue strip right there, and the glue strip right there. So that's the reason why it's kind of hard to take this thing apart. Anyways, like that, disconnect that. There's a screw under here under this Lenovo brand. Another screw right here. And another screw right there. Okay, so we got those three screws out. Now we take this CD-ROM out. And what we want to do is we want to disconnect this cable right here. That's the battery cable. Like that, like that, like that, like that. And like that. Okay, so this is whole thing disconnected. Flip it over. Oh, you see, the thing comes out easy. So here is the jack right there. Let's see what we can do here. Disconnect that. And we need to disconnect the wireless cable. The wireless card itself. Alright, so set this aside. And alright, so here we got this cable right here for the screen. Don't break your nails. Like that. Like that. And like that, okay? Alrighty, so that's that. And there's one screw right there underneath, right there, underneath the heatsink, which we probably still need to remove it because it's too close to the jack. So let's remove the heatsink. Okay, like that. So if you decide to send us the motherboard, do remove the heatsink and do remove the fan. Okay, we have to clean up the fan because it's a lot of garbage in there. Okay, so fan is clean. Alright, and we got one more cable right here that we need to disconnect. Like that, and set that aside so that you will not forget it. Now we have four screws right here for the hard drive. One, two, three, and four. You see, I know how to count till four. And we got one screw right here for the board, so like that, like that. Let's see. Oh, and that's the one I was talking about before. Like that. Good job. Remove that, and that's your jack right there. And the problem usually the rear arm breaks. So the goal here is to insulate the parts that are those components right here needs to be insulated so that they won't fall off the motherboard. And this part right here, you don't want to damage this part in any way, shape or form. This part and that part and those two components here. Because once you damage them, it's going to take half a day for you to put it all back in proper place, to solder it all in proper place. So you need to take your time on this preparation. It's a lot like, it's a lot like painting a house, where the taping takes the longest amount of time, the prep, but the soldering itself isn't really all that time consuming. So make sure the tape is in fact taping everything down. So here, make sure all of the components, the tape gonna hold the tape, I mean the tape gonna hold everything down for sure. It keeps the component on the motherboard and it doesn't let the heat through to the component. And we need to insulate this plastic because the plastic melts sometimes. Alright, so what we're gonna do is, I overdid the insulation on this side. I would not be able to desolder it if there is insulation covering the that's not acceptable for me. Okay. Alright, so what I want to do, I want to run another layer of insulation on top because I don't want these components to be damaged. Is it in focus? It's not in focus. Okay. So let's run another insulation like that. And like that. Good job. Good job, good job. All right, wonderful. So now I'm more protected, that is. All right, so here. All right. All right, let's get rid of that refocusing on this camera. It doesn't like the focus for some reason. Just give me 1 second. Thank you.
Alright, so that's the old one, that's the new one. You see the difference? The rear leg basically on the old one fell off. The new one? Alrighty. Thank you.
Alright, so let me show you the final product. Here is the final product, like a factory soldering. Looks good, huh? Yeah, I know. Some people accuse us of not replacing the jack. They always say, did you even replace the jack? Yes, we did replace the jack, and if you look closely, you will see some work on it. So, yeah, let's put it all back together. Like that, like that, like that, like that, and like that. Okay. This is really easy system to work on. As long as you can take the keyboard out properly. Alright, so for some reason, I don't see why it doesn't want to go back in properly. Here, let's see. Like that. Like that, no? Nope. Doesn't want to go in. Well, it does want to go in. I was just looking at the screw right here, which is not sitting correctly in there. That way it should be fine. Okay, so it did go in fine. Here you want to connect cable right here, obviously, right? Yeah, you want to connect that cable right here. All right, so you want to connect this cable right here. Okay, close that. Now what you want to do is connect this cable right here, connect the hard drive, connect the video card, the screen. It doesn't want to get connected for some reason properly. Let's try one more time. Like that, like that, like that. Let's push it in there, okay. And this thing has to be connected like that. Okay, all good. Now let's get some screws out of there. Put it right here. This is gonna go right here. That screw gonna go right there. Okay. For some reason, again, no focus, no proper focus. Anyways, four screws for the hard drive go right here. And we got one more screw for the wireless card. Alright, good job. Okay, and now it's time to put the... This is out of the ledge right there. Okay, so make sure the hinges are properly tightened. So we need to put thermal paste onto the CPU. So let's put some thermal paste right here and right there. Okay, good job. That was that. And that's the reason I didn't take off the gloves yet, because thermal paste is extremely toxic for the skin. Alright, so we got two more screws. Two silver screws that go one right here, one right there. And we got this fan cable. that needs to go in like that and like that. So we screw down this thing right here, that thing right there. Alrighty, looks good. I just forgot to check if the plus and minus are shorting or not, so let's see. Nope, everything's good. We got the minus and we got the plus. Good job. So yeah, that's pretty much all you have to do here. Make sure that's like that. You might also want to put some tape on top of the wireless cable, because sometimes they come off the motherboard, come off the wireless card, they start to fly all over the place and they short the motherboard. So here, let's put the bottom cover back on. Here is a little trick. You need to put this wire through that hole right there. So, alright. Let's put the CD-ROM back in. Like that. Let's flip this thing over. Let's open up the screen. Switch the camera. Okay. Focus. Focus, yeah, okay. And we got one cable right here. Alright, we got the power cable, the battery cable right there, which I wanna connect in a few seconds. Just need to like that. Like that. And was this one right here too? Yeah, okay. Good job. So what I wanna do is connect the battery cable right about, well, give me a second here. Can I connect the cable? Well, no. Need to connect the battery cable first, because it's not gonna be comfortable to connect. Okay. Alright, so once the battery cable is in, make sure you guide it in like that. And here, this cable you need to connect like that. Close down the hinge. Alright, and yeah, so the glue under the keyboard is what messes things up. Let's switch to the bigger view. Alright, so the most important screws are right here near the hinges. And let's see the battery. Keep the battery in place. And the sides right there. Right here, the one right here on the front, the one right here, and the one right here. Everything else is standard. Well, I will find the two missing screws after I test the laptop. I don't want to waste time while I'm looking for the screws around here. So let's hope the charger is fine. And the way we're gonna test the charger is by shoving something like that into here and measure the voltage. Alright, yep, we got the voltage. Remove that, remove that. And let's connect it to the new. It doesn't move, it doesn't wiggle anymore. Do we have any lights? Oh yeah, I mean, we got something on the screen right there, and I got two lights right here in the front. Alright guys, so I'm gonna test out the keyboard, the touchpad, and the wireless card. Thanks so much for watching. You guys have a good day. Leave a like, subscribe if you want. Thank you. Bye.